Hello YouTube, I'm going to present you today how to use a multimeter like this, a very cheap one. You can find it anywhere, in any countries, with a couple of dollars, couple of pounds, whatever you want. It's a Chinese thing, very cheap, very easy to use. I'm going to start now with the DC voltage. You can see in this left part is rated from 200 millivolts, 2000, 20, 200, and a couple of more, 1000 or whatever. Okay, I'm gonna try to test it now. Let's hook up to a small battery. This is a 1.5 volts, if it still has a charge. And so basically, we're gonna put it in the 2000 milliamps. So if you want a accurate reading, we're gonna put it like this. It doesn't matter which leads, we're gonna connect it. And also you can use the multimeter for finding the polarity, you know, plus and minus, whatever. I'm just gonna try it now to see if it sticks. Okay, here you go, it's showing 1642 volts, so it's nearly accurate. It's 1.6 volts, it's got a charge. Now we're gonna measure, this is a rechargeable batteries recovered for a laptop. Let's see if there is still charge on it. They are quite old, but still we got a few projects for these ones. That is showing one basically is like an error because the voltage is over 2000 milliamps or 2 millivolts, sorry, 2 volts. We're gonna put it in the 20. Now look, this is the actual voltage, is 3.46 volts because this is a 3.5 rechargeable batteries and it still has a charge. Here you go, 3.45. Okay, so this is good. I'm gonna try another one to see if come on, not messing around. Jesus Christ. Okay. And also this one is good. It has 3.32 volts. And we actually now we are connected right. You can see red one is for plus and the black one is for minus. Okay, this is the DC part. So from here, all over here, you can measure DC voltage. This is the off position, when nothing is shown. This part is for AC voltage, basically what is in the mains. This part is measuring amps, all over here. Okay, this is for oscilloscope, not quite. This setting here is for continuity. Basically, if you can find if a wire is broken or it's got continuity. These wires normally now, like it shows on a thing, shows once, it's got no continuity. When we're gonna hook up to it, you can see a sound and it's got continuity. Yeah. Also, we're gonna test on this wire. It's got two leads, the leads are connected. So basically it's gonna be a closed circuit, and if you're gonna put the wires here, showing again, yeah, the sound, there is continuity. I'm gonna unhook this one, that's it, like an open circuit, put it there again, nope, it's showing one, yeah, show no continuity. Also this feature, we can test it with the LED to see if it's good or bad or damage or stuff. Let's see it now. We're gonna hook up to it and we have to see some readings. There, showing one. Let me try thing. Look, have you see it? There's a bad connection here. Come on. Basically, you can see some readings, yeah? So this is a actual is gooding It's a running wall. I'm gonna connect it to a battery to see if the meter is right. You can see the light. Yeah, this is working. I do have another one, which I know for sure that it is broken. I'm gonna connect it to the battery. Nothing. Right. Other way around. One. Nope. I'm gonna put it to the meter. You're gonna show nothing, just one. You can see one. The other way around. One. Basically, this light bulb is done. Okay. In this part here, like you can see now the ohms sign, you can measure resistance, basically resistor. Here you can test transistor to see if it's NPN or PNP transistor. And now I'm going to show you a feature, you know, to measure amps, basically how much LED or something else is drawing current from a circuit. We do have here a battery, a small LED recovered from an energy saving light bulb. I'm going to connect it to the battery. You can see it got light. Okay. Now we're going to put it in the ohm, in the amps area, like this, on the 10 scale. And we're going to move the pin from middle to the upper part. That's it, it's connected. Now we're going to hook up a lead and the other one to the battery. It lights and meter should figure out something. Nope, not great. Come on, man. Showing 10 milliamps maybe or none. I think it's lower than, let's see, in the 20 area. Nope. Basically what the meter shows now is not drawing any power, but this is not an accurate one. Like 10 milliamps. No, 10 milliamps because the battery, we're gonna measure it up. The battery is quite low. Let's see how many voltage it's got. Like, look, 8 point something. So it's less than, this is a 12 volts LED bulb. And we are drawing less power. As you can see, that's basically it. The functions of a cheap multimeter, and you can use it to do basic stuff, you know, for no-brainers, whatever. That was it. Sure. See you next time, bitches.